Hello, my name is Fabrice and this is Animated Anatomy. In my previous video, I have talked about the neuroendocrine system and the pituitary gland. Now I will talk about the spinal pathways. You see, spinal cord is like a highway. It is a place where terabytes and terabytes of information pass from the brain to the body and vice versa. This is why we call these tracts or pathways ascending or descending. We will now study closely these tracts and explain their structure. Hello, and I finally found some time to do the video on the spinal cord pathways. Now, in this video, I will also introduce something new, and that will be a small quiz where you'll be able to answer the questions and to see whether you can proceed and watch the second half of the video or not. We were going to make a quiz in the middle of the video after I explain the basic components. Now, there is the somatosensory organization, the motor organization, and the spinocerebellar tracts. I think it would be best to start with the motor organization. So basically, when we talk about the motor, those are the descending or the efferent pathways. Now, they can be divided into the pyramidal tracts and the extrapyramidal tracts. Now, the pyramidal tracts, one is right here, and it is called the lateral corticospinal tract. Okay. It's the lateral corticospinal tract. And there's also the anterior corticospinal tract. For orientation purposes, this right here is the anterior side, this is the posterior side, and this is the lateral side, okay? So this is why this one right here was the lateral and this one was the anterior. But that was not all, you know, as I mentioned, those are the pyramidal tracts. Now there are also the extrapyramidal tracts, and those would be here the vestibulospinal tract and the olivospinal tract right here. Now we also have the reticulospinal tract, and one here and here as well. And there is also the rubrospinal tract. So those were basically the motor or the descending or the efferent pathways. And I will explain you later where they come from and what are their function and everything. But right now I'm just explaining you the basics. I'm explaining you the names of which tracts we have, and then I'm gonna like dissect that, and we're gonna analyze the tracts and where they go, where they come from, and what do they do. So let's start with the sensory or the ascending or the afferent pathways. Basically, the pathways that bring the information from the body to the brain. So here you have the gracile fasciculus. And right next to it, a little bit more laterally, you have the cuneate fasciculus. Now, I'm really sorry I started this video without previously explaining you what were you looking at. So if you look at here, this is the white matter. This is where the axons are. They conduct the signal. They are in the myelin sheath. It makes them conduct the signal much faster. Here you have the gray matter. This is where the cell bodies are. And here, this right here, this was the central canal. The spinal cord. The central canal is going all the way cranially up there, and it enters fourth ventricle. Now you can learn about that in my videos about ventricular system of the brain. This right here was the dorsal median sulcus of the spinal cord. Now when I mentioned the gracile fasciculus and the cuneate fasciculus right here, they together create the dorsal column. And on the front here, you had the ventral median, not sulcus, but fissure, the ventral median fissure. Now there are a few more things I want you to know, and then we can continue to our little quiz and to see how well you understood the things I was saying. This right here was the spinocerebellar tract and the posterior one. Of course, there is also the anterior spinocerebellar tract right here. Now there are a few more things left that I want you to know, and then we can continue to our little quiz. Well, there is the anterior system with the lateral spinothalamic tract right here and the anterior spinothalamic tract right here. There are also the spino-olivary fibers right here. Now we can start our little quiz. I will basically pinpoint a certain structure, and I want you to click at the right answer. The answers will be displayed here. If you don't click at the right answer, it will automatically send you to the point of the video where I explain that, okay? And then you can see it where you made a mistake. If you click the right thing, it's just going to continue playing the video. So let's start. I want you to click at the name of this structure right here. You have 4 seconds. Now I want you to click at the name of this structure right here. Now you can click on the name of this structure right here. Okay, so far if you didn't click at any answer, well, that's bad. You should like go back and click at some answer in order for the quiz to work. And if you clicked and you passed, that means you answered correctly. Now, I want you to tell me or to click on the name of this part right here. Now, if you did click on the answers and it didn't send you back, that means you have learned the basic structure of the spinal cord cross section. Good job. Now we should start to explain the functions and where these tracts come from and where do they go. Now that I've explained names and the position of these tracts, I would like to proceed to explain where they come from and what do they do. I'd like to start with the motor and the descending or the efferent pathways. Here we had the lateral corticospinal tract and here we had the anterior corticospinal tract. They belong to the pyramidal tracts. Now we're looking from the lateral point of view at our brain, and that's really great because we can see the cerebral cortex where these tracts originate clearly. Here you had the Brodmann areas 1, 2, and 3, the primary somatosensory cortex. And here you had the primary motor cortex, the Brodmann area number 4. You also had the Brodmann area number 6, which is ventrally from this primary motor cortex, and that is actually the premotor cortex. It's a supplementary motor cortex or the secondary motor cortex. So when they originate from there, I want to show you where they go. So I'm going to make a frontal section of our brain and we're going to look at it from the anterior point of view. And this is really great right here. I like it. So they originate from the cortex of our brain here and then they go all the way down and they go through the internal capsule laterally from the thalamus. This here is the thalamus. They go lateral from the thalamus and then they go through the cerebral crust. That is basically the anterior portion of the cerebral peduncle. Then they go through the pons and all the way down to the pyramids where they exchange sides. And 90% of the fibers go on the contralateral side here. The remaining 10 goes down on the ipsilateral side. And then they synapse with the lower motor neurons down there. Now if we go back to our illustration, we had also the extrapyramidal tracts. We had the reticulospinal tracts here. And we also had the olivospinal tract here, as well as the vestibulospinal tract here. We also had the rubrospinal tract here. Now you can tell by their name that they originate from the nuclei and from the midbrain. If you don't know these names and if you don't know these nuclei, then you should check out my video and my software about the midbrain and where I explained the midbrain, I illustrated it as well. Now I want to talk about the sensory and the afferent pathways. Now I want you to know that we divide these things into two groups. We divide it into conscious sensory information and we divide it in the afferent information that is not conscious, the one that goes to cerebellum, for example. So here we have the spinocerebellar tracts here, the anterior and the posterior one. And as far as the somatosensory organization goes, we had the anterolateral system, including the lateral spinothalamic tract here and the anterior spinothalamic tract here. This over here is the dorsal column, basically a column that consists of the gracile fasciculus here, and it also consists of a cuneate fasciculus. The tracts that carry the conscious information, the information that we're fully aware of, for example, when you touch something, some object, or whatever you want, they actually have two ways the way they carry information, and I'm going to illustrate both of them. You have the first order neuron here in the ganglion, okay? This is some kind of ganglion here. Okay, let's say it's a big ganglion. And this one can enter the spinal cord through the dorsal horn of the gray matter and then immediately connect to the second order neuron, and then the second order neuron goes to the goes to the contralateral side and then goes all the way up through the thalamus. Now, it doesn't always have to be this way. You can have, again, a ganglion here. And the first order neuron enters the spinal cord through the dorsal horn of the gray matter. And then it does not connect to the second order neuron. It just keeps going up. And when it reaches the pyramids, it connects to the second order neuron. And then the second order neuron goes to the contralateral side and then goes all the way up to the thalamus. And from there, you have the third order neuron, which basically goes from the thalamus to the primary somatosensory cortex. Now, to make some changes and move away from the neuroanatomy, in my next video, I will talk about the nose anatomy and the nose job. What is the nose made of, and what surgeons aim to fix with these surgeries, and what they aim to achieve? You can watch that video here. You can also watch my previous video here. If you like my lessons and want to purchase my software, then you can go to my website, Animated Anatomy, right here. If you don't have money to purchase my software, then at least make sure you subscribe here for more future virtual dissection classes that I release here regularly. Thank you.